One of the things that has been driving Donald Trump crazy since the start of this hush money trial in Manhattan is the fact that he has been treated like any other criminal defendant. Donald Trump not only believes that he himself is above the law, but he also views himself as above everyone else. You're not as good looking as me. You're not as good of an athlete as me. You're not as rich as me. You don't have as beautiful women as I have. You don't have the power that I had as president of the United States. I am better than you. That is what Trump genuinely believes. And he has believed that for his entire life. So when he has to go into that courtroom every single day, when he has to go through the same steps and processes as any other criminal defendant, that is what has really gotten under his skin. Having to ask permission to have a day off from the judge. He's never had to ask permission before. He's just done whatever the hell he wants. And we got a good example of it this week on Monday, when Donald Trump was whining about the fact that the defense team had to give their closing statements first, then the prosecutors got to go last, so that's the last thing the jury heard. Trump said it's totally unfair. Why can't the defense go last? Well, because it's actually New York state law. It's actually state law in most states. And where it's not state law and the defense is allowed to go last, the prosecution is actually allowed to give a rebuttal. So it's how it works across the country with any criminal defendant. And that drove Trump crazy to the point where former federal prosecutor or U.S. Attorney Joyce Vance said, Trump is finally being treated like every other defendant. And that is what he really objects to. It's not the fact that he's on trial. It's the fact that he's not getting that special treatment anymore. He's finding out exactly how the justice system is supposed to work. And here's the thing. People like Donald Trump, these wealthy, powerful white guys, typically don't go through this. You know, it is very rare to see somebody with Trump's money, with his power, with his status, to actually have to go through court this way. You know, we have seen time and time again when these white-collar criminals get off the hook. They don't have to show up. They get sweetheart plea deals and they go back to criming on Wall Street, right? Trump is almost being made an example of for those people. And I think it's a good example to set. I think it's time that the wealthy, powerful white men in this country understand that none of you are above the law. You've gotten away with too many things for far too long, and things are going to change. And hopefully that is the message of this trial. Because it's not just about Donald Trump. It's about showing the wealthy, the powerful, that this is how justice can work. You're not always going to get those sweetheart treatments. Trump's finding it out the hard way. And hopefully after this, a lot of those other white-collar criminals in this country that have had it too good for too long can learn the same lesson. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.